Coming up, we take a closer look at updates across the Surface product portfolio, and we're going to meet engineering leader Jochen Siegl to see how the Surface team is delivering its goals for performance, quality, and design with the all-new Surface Laptop 3, now also available with the larger 15-inch display, the updated Surface Pro 7 with the 10th Gen Intel processor and USB-C connectivity, and the Surface Pro X, a new ARM-based device with built-in LTE, next-generation Surface Pen, and more. So welcome, Jochen. It's great to have you on the show.
Thanks for having me.
So usually when we cover Surface announcements on Microsoft Mechanics, we're only lucky enough to focus on individual devices. But today, we're going to cover a few. So what are some of the things that we focused on with these updates?
Well, as I'm going to show you today, there's a lot of shared innovation across our whole lineup. The fit and finish is our signature, and with every generation, we balance the battery life, the portability, and the comfort with premium design, so we can get the technology out of your way and get you back into your flow. You will see that we have new color options for more personalization and new material options that are more robust and easy to keep clean. The devices are significantly faster than the previous generations. You will also notice that we introduce a new ultra-thin 15-inch laptop. And one of the biggest themes you will see in this device lineup is chipset diversity. The laptop 15-inch also comes with a new AMD Ryzen Microsoft Surface Edition for retail, which is 2.5 faster than Surface Laptop 2. And this makes it a great all-arounder for work and play. And for our 2.1 class of devices, we are introducing the new Surface Pro X. That features the new Microsoft SQ1 ARM chipset co-designed with Qualcomm to enhance mobility and connectivity.
It's great to see that with this new generation of Pro 7 and laptop, we've stayed consistent really wherever possible with previous generations of the device.
Right, and with every generation, we're listening to your feedback. So what you see with Surface Pro 7 and Surface Laptop is that we focus on keeping them compatible with your existing Surface peripherals and accessories. Take Surface Laptop, for example, where everybody loves the design. We made it much faster than the previous generation without adding weight or making it thicker. For those of you using Surface in your organization, we also wanted a device that is easy to repair. Laptop 3 is all of that, but much more without compromising design.
So I'm sure a lot of engineering work really went into retaining the aesthetics while making the devices both more performant and also more serviceable. Before we go there, you mentioned shared innovation. So what are some of the changes we've made to connectivity and the internals to make these a better generation of devices?
Right. So these are the things that many of you always ask for. For example, it's connectivity, as you're saying. You will notice that we have replaced the mini display port in the same place with a USB-C 3.1 port to help with more options for peripherals and charging. And now you can connect a wider range of displays. In fact, now you can drive up to 2 4K monitors at 60 Hz via one cable. People love the Alcantara fabric and its luxurious feel. And you will find this on our keyboards for Pro and on the laptop. And of course, we have faster processors. So Pro 7 and laptop device line come with a new quad-core 10th generation Intel Core i5 and i7 mobile processors. We've also standardized on faster, more power-efficient LPDDR4 memory across our Intel devices. Surface Pro 7 is available with up to 16 GB of RAM, and you can get the laptop with up to 32 GB of RAM. All of them have Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth 5 support.
And these are some really great core generational changes, really across Pro 7 and laptop, but can we dig deeper in on the 15-inch laptop?
Oh, of course. Let's start with the new and improved PixelSense displays. It's the same magic 3:2 aspect ratio that is standard across our complete family. It's a 2496 by 1664 resolution and is color calibrated for 100% sRGB color space right at the factory. It's even brighter than Laptop 2 while consuming less power. And supports the latest generation of the G5 touch chip with up to 10 finger, multi-touch and inking. We improved the lock-on experience, and when opening the lid, the laptop wakes up and locks in automatically to Windows Desktop, so you're right back into your flow. It was important to not break the line of the design with a finger notch and still be able to open the laptop with one finger. This is also possible because of the improved Windows Hello camera. And this is also true for both Surface Pro product.
Right, I'm going to pause you there for a second because I know as we start to approach the microphone and speakers, I think that we should spend a moment to talk about the work some of the team has done with regards to audio.
Well, from day one with Surface, we made sure that audio is at the heart of our design, so we can enhance collaboration productivity from device to device. We started premium audio capture journey with Surface Studio. And now on the Surface Laptop 3, we have introduced a new dual microphone system with active voice optimization that we call the Studio Microphones. This is also true for the other devices we are introducing today. This is our best microphone solution to date for voice. It allows us to capture sound and blend out the background noise. So team calls are much clearer, voices are crisp, and it's easy to capture the voice when you dictate in Word, OneNote, or PowerPoint. And then for the audio playback, Omnisonic speakers fire through the keyboard without showing visible ports or opening for the speakers. This is a very complex setup as audio translates through the movable keyboard, keys, and the backlight. And our new design is in fact much more efficient, driving a more solid bass and a much richer sound. As we have added Dolby Audio Premium processing, it is also helping to widen the frequency response, enhances the dialogue, maximize the loudness while controlling distortions, so you're having definitely a much enhanced experience as before.
Right, it's really great to see the audio focus here because it's often overlooked, especially on thinner devices, but why don't we continue on the device tour? Because I know that one of the really important things in terms of interacting with the device is also how you interact with the keyboards to boost productivity. What have we done there?
Glass trackpad is 20% larger than the previous generation, and even most importantly, provides a very satisfying click. Listen to this, please. The typing experience on the backlit keyboard is optimized for readability in various lighting conditions too, and it's much quieter and more comfortable than it was ever before. This is our most accessible laptop ever. We have added accessibility bumps on keys, including the F4 and F8 function keys, and a power button so that you don't accidentally turn off your machine.
So all these improvements that you've mentioned, they're true for both the 15-inch and 13-inch, right?
Oh, yes, they are. And the other exciting thing that you probably have noticed, now we're having a full metal cover on the 13-inch laptop as well. And to personalize the experience even further, in addition to the two Alcantara color options, there are now three full metal color options available for laptop as well.
So you mentioned before that the Surface laptop has been really redesigned from the inside out, but from the outside, the device looks pretty consistent with a laptop too.
Yes, and there are a few things that you will see, and a few might not. Moving to the sides, there is where you can see we have removed the antenna windows and made the design much more cleaner than before. The laptop has both USB-C and USB-A ports, a Surface Connect, and a 3.5 audio microphone jack as well. But as we move inside the device, you will realize we have completely re-architected the device. The motherboard, the enclosures, the battery, everything is different and new. And we made the laptop 3 more easily repairable. An authorized repair technician can now remove the top to access the inside to replace or remove the SSD. And this is one of our top enterprise requests, and we are on the start of a new journey with our new laptop. The drives are M.2 NVMe SSDs and available in 128GB up to 1TB options.
This is going to be really great news, having that removable SSD for IT departments that are really looking to preserve their hardware investments for their organizations. But switching gears, though, we have a brand new member of the Surface family called the Surface Pro X. How does this raise the bar for how ARM-based Windows devices are built?
Oh, well, Jeremy, we have re-engineered the Surface Pro X, and we started from a complete new slate. It's our reimagination of the 2.1 form factor, and we're innovating everywhere. And at 7.3 millimeters, it's our thinnest Surface Pro ever. And the first thing you will notice is an all-new keyboard with a docked Surface Pen. The backlit keyboard is specifically designed for this device. The new pen is sleek and slim. It has wireless charging so that the pen is accessible and always ready for use. And the best thing is, now in the pocket, you can never lose the pen. We were also able to introduce an even larger trackpad on the keyboard. It's our largest display in the 2.1 category. It is 13-inch, but yet in the same footprint of the previous generation. It features a 2880 by 1920 pixel screen, a beautiful 450 nits brightness screen, and of course the magic 3x2 aspect ratio. As you would expect, we also have 10-point touch and inking support. You will also notice that despite being so thin, we managed to allow for two USB-C ports and our Surface Connect.
So can you explain more about this ARM-based chipset?
Oh, of course. We worked with Qualcomm for the last 3 years and developed this chip to make it optimized to run along the way with our operating system and the firmware. And first off, our goal was to make it the fastest ARM processor running Windows. The CPU's clock speed is 3 GHz. Its GPU runs at a crazy 2.1 teraflops to meet demanding graphics workloads. It also lets you drive two 4K 60Hz monitors from a single USB-C cable. We've used 2133 MHz LPDDR4X memory, and it features a built-in 4G LTE advanced pro modem, and it works with both a nano SIM and an eSIM. And you remember the removable SSD we just looked at before? Well, we've got this on Surface Pro X2, as well with M.2 NVMe options up to 512 GB. All this combined makes it one of the best performing portable devices in the market. So we are giving you the laptop level performance with Surface Pro X.
So this looks like a really great mobile device. And for the IT admins that are watching, these Windows 10 and ARM devices, they're using Windows 10 Pro. So you can domain join or Azure AD join them and manage them. And they'll also run 32-bit Windows apps. So some really great updates really across the board. So you mentioned earlier, we've done a lot of work in terms of battery life across the whole lineup. Can you tell us more about what the team's done there?
Oh, of course. It's always important for us to create the right balance for a device. But we don't want to cut corners on our display, and we use some of the best displays available in the market. For example, the new laptop displays have the same resolution and pixels per inch as before, but they are brighter and yet they are more power efficient than the previous generation. And one important, often overlooked aspect of battery life is how quickly you can charge it. All of the devices you see here today support fast charging to allow you to charge the battery up to 80% about an hour. That's great when you're in between meetings or when you're in the airport and you need a quick charge to hop on the plane.
And something also for our device admin specifically, it's worth mentioning that we've also made significant enhancements and investments in how you can manage Surface devices all the way down to the UEFI firmware using Surface Enterprise Management Mode tools. Now, this also means you can manage firmware and device level controls on these managed devices while they're running. And of course, you can provision new Surface devices with the latest Windows Autopilot options. So Jochen, when can we start expecting to see these in market and what can we do to learn more?
This lineup will be ready for the holiday season, and for businesses, you can start working with your Microsoft Surface representatives today. Chances are, they will be able to let you go hands-on with one of these beautiful devices. Also, check out microsoft.com/surface to learn more.
It's a really great tip, and I'm also looking forward to it. By the way, if you haven't yet, please hit subscribe and keep coming back as we continue to cover the latest tech updates across Microsoft on Microsoft Mechanics. So thanks one more time, Jochen, for introducing us to all the updates across all the new Surface devices. And here from the Microsoft Technology Center in Bellevue, Washington, thanks for watching.